You're watching 8-Bit Days a Week, and we're gonna play Ridge Racer Type 4 on the PlayStation Classic. And you've probably seen me already play this game in my earlier video. And I did note that there seems to be like a frame rate issue here. Because I really played this a lot before. I love this game. And I'm quite pleased that they included it. But I also noted why would they not include the other racing games, Gran Turismo or Need for Speed? I mean, any of those. I thought those would have been a no-brainer, so to speak. So you could clearly see that there is also some performance issue here. It's not there. It's really not a good representation. Alright, let's see if I can do better than the last time I played this. I really liked the Ridge Racer series. I played the first one, Revolution, Rage Racer, even the one for the N64, which I do believe got re-released as well in the DS. I played those two as well. And if I remember correct, this also came out for like the Android. Played that as well. I can't believe I played that as well. I hate Android. I mean, touch screen games. And there was also like an entry for the Xbox 360 and PS3, like Ridge Racer 6. Oh yeah. I played 5 on PS2. I do believe that's one of the early PS2 titles. And I know they're mostly fictional cars, but I do enjoy unlocking the cars in this game, even though they're not really like licensed, like in Gran Turismo. I was hoping they'd have like a Tekken car. All right, I'm drifting too much. That I admit. See, this along with Gran Turismo 2, they're like the only games I actually care to watch the replay with. Oftentimes, I don't really care how how it looks like on the replay as long as I finish with a good standing. But anyway, let's go ahead and proceed to the next race, and hopefully I win again. I used to try to actually read through the story there, but it's cringy, I guess. It's not really a good story. Or it's pointless, I guess. And I don't even know why, at the time, they all made a big deal about having the character Reiko Nagase. She just appears in the intro, I think. Just for fan service. And that's it. And pointless. Ah!
Wow.
That is dark. I should try to retry already. I'm not sure if I'm gonna win this after that huge blunder. But let me just see it through. See, the thing is, you always have to finish first here if you want to get the good cars. And you could still proceed even if you finish like third or something. But the car that they provide would be of lesser quality, I guess. I know there are dark areas in this game, but that's probably because it's on an HD TV. But it's way darker than I remember. Or maybe the PS Classic tends to have its brightness on the darker side, I guess. I think I'm gonna make it. I'm still fourth place. See, I'm gonna qualify to continue, but I won't get the nice car. If you're a completist, this should be fine actually, because you still get to unlock something. And if you want to unlock everything, you're gonna need to intentionally lose, I guess. Unfortunately, I lose. I qualify, but I lose. That's fine. Anyway, that's Ridge Racer Type 4. There seems to be issues I would notice, and I'm not even a like a hardcore that goes through each each frame or something, but it's clearly obvious to me. And despite this being not a PAL title, there seems to be really something with that frame rate, which is unfortunate. All right, might as well save. At least I get a car. Maybe eventually I'll unlock everything. Since we're using like a virtual memory card here, we're not managing like the 15 blocks of before. And okay. Let's see the car. Regalo. Okay, it's a nice car. Could have been better.
Okay.
That's it for this one, Ridge Racer. You've been watching 8-Bit Days a Week. Please do leave a like, subscribe, comment, whatever. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.